So the way I design the formulas will automatically extract the data from the reports that are downloaded from the seller center. All you have to do is just copy-paste the reports and start analyzing. Overcharged shipping fee has been a big headache for Shopee sellers for the past few months. Today, I'll share a little of what I know and solve the overcharged shipping fee with Shopee, including a free tool to assist you on this matter. Watch until the end. It is not a new issue for Shopee to overcharge the shipping fee on orders. In fact, I have encountered it myself in one of my shops, even though that shop has a low volume of orders. So I can't start to imagine what those sellers with hundreds to thousands of orders per day are facing. As Shopee did not provide a tool in the seller center to check on these issues. At least at the time of writing this script, there's none. The amount overcharged is ranging from few ringgits to nearly 1,000, according to some other sellers in the Facebook group. How can this be happening? I'm not a professional software engineer. I'm just a seller that know one or two things about software and programming. So if what I'm about to say is wrong, please correct me in the comment section below. First, sellers have to understand the terms estimated shipping fee and actual shipping fee. Estimated shipping fee is when a customer placing order, the system of Shopee will calculate the shipping fee based on the weight and dimension reseller input into the product details. The actual shipping fee is where the logistic company receives and processes your parcels. They will input actual weight and dimensions into their own system. Thus, the shipping fee is calculated. After that, Shopee will retrieve this shipping fee using API. If you do not know what an API is, in short, it is just a set of tools for software on different platforms to talk to each other. So the unreasonable high actual shipping fee is most likely to originate from courier company. It can be human error or just a system glitch. We won't know for sure. If you try to reach out Shopee customer service, they will ask for the actual parcel weight and dimension. I believe this information is what Shopee will use to open a support ticket with the courier company to check on the overcharged shipping fee. Normally, it will be sufficient if you just provide the figures, but I highly recommend providing more solid evidence, like photos or videos of the parcel with the shipping label being readable. It would be better if you are able to provide more order IDs where the orders have the same SKUs and similar regions of destinations. Some might be saying that this is an extra burden for order processing. Well, if Shopee do not provide a way for us to avoid being overcharged, I guess we have to do more work in order to do less, such as installing a CCTV on the packing station, which here stands for cover carton televisions, or design your workflow to include snapping a photo of the parcel before handing out to the courier company. Normally, sellers will only notice the overcharged shipping fee when they see the order completion notifications. Sadly, there's no quick and easy way to check before order completion.
When I made the first version of the template for Shopee fees calculator, I prepared the columns for SKU weight, shipping fee, and shipping rebate, which I never used for that calculator. My initial intention was to include the shipping fee calculator, but during the process, I found that the shipping fees in the order report only had estimated shipping fee. Even when the order details in the seller center turned into actual shipping fee, but there's still no column for actual shipping fee in the order report. Instead, the estimated shipping fee column has an updated amount, but I find that to be inconsistent with every courier company. So I created another page in the template for calculating the shipping fees. It took me some time to nail the calculations because there are situations like normal shipping fee paid by customer, shipping subsidy by Shopee, seller shipping promotion, or seller bear shipping fee, and seller bear the extras when the actual shipping fee is greater than both subsidies and buyer paid shipping fee combined. Why is it so hard to calculate these figures, you might be asking? Because I wanted to create a template that can help sellers in the easiest way possible. So the way I design the formulas will automatically extract the data from the reports that are downloaded from the seller center. All you have to do is just copy-paste the reports and start analyzing. To use this shipping fees calculator, download the income report from the seller center. Select the entire report range and hit copy. Go to the income report sheet in the template. Make sure there is no data here, and right-click on the cell A1, choose Match Destinations Formatting, or Paste Values Only. Go to the Shipping Fee tab. The Shipping Error columns will list out the amount of potential error, including overcharge and undercharge shipping fee, which is further broken down in the next two columns. For overcharge, you will need to contact Shopee to correct the actual shipping fee like I mentioned earlier. Undercharge means you are earning extra from undercharged shipping fees. For these two situations, you might need to analyze the SKUs in those orders and correct the product weight and dimensions. The seller bear columns shows how much you are covering the shipping fee for the customer, such as the seller shipping promotion you created in the marketing center. Or check the I will cover the shipping fee option in product page. And last one, more than both subsidies column shows when the actual shipping fee is greater than both subsidies and buyer paid shipping fee combined, which is also bear by the seller. To the right are the order ID lists for all four situations. Order IDs are only censored for demonstration purposes. On top is the total amount for each situation. And lastly, the description for the columns.
I have created templates for both Excel and Google Sheets. For the Excel version, you will need Office 365 or Office 2021 because some of the functions are only available in these versions of Excel. Download them through the link in the video description below. I might not have covered all the situations of shipping fee calculations. Do let me know in the comment section if you find any error or uncover situations in the templates. Check out this video for how I extract the data from the reports in these templates. And YouTube think you might want to see this video. Subscribe to my channel. I share tips and templates to help manage your e-commerce business. See you in my next video.